In a world full of superlatives, what do you say when you really do have something extraordinary? Sometimes, just seeing is believing. This is Sunrise Company. For more than 30 years, Sunrise Company has set a precedent by creating private country club communities that remain unrivaled. Each an impressive creation unto itself, yet all similar in their embrace of nature and unsurpassed style. Places where dreams are pursued and fulfilled every day. Within these breathtakingly beautiful communities, renowned golf courses have been designed by legends of the game. Jack Nicklaus, Pete Dye, Ted Robinson, Arnold Palmer, and Fred Couples. Courses that have hosted such celebrated events as the Bob Hope Chrysler Classic, the Skins Game, and the Grand Slam of Golf. It takes an extraordinary team to bring this vision to life. Founder and CEO William Bone has created a company that reflects his personal integrity and devotion to excellence. Under the leadership of the senior management team that averages 15 years with Sunrise Company, each team member is mentored to achieve personal and professional success. This is a place where diversity, imagination, curiosity, and creativity are celebrated. And so people are drawn here, the best new talent and the sharpest minds in the business, to become one of the select few who shape the future of this visionary company. Sunrise Company's approach to development is as innovative as the communities they create. This is Sunrise Company. For over 30 years, builder of America's finest country club communities.
Looking for a place with its own railroad line, including a Victorian train station? Michael Jackson's Neverland Valley Ranch will soon be on the market, and the sellers think it could fetch as much as $90 million. A Los Angeles real estate firm is hoping to find a buyer for the shuttered 2,600-acre estate, carnival rides and exotic animals not included. Jackson bought the property in Santa Barbara County, California for $19 million in 1987, back when he was at the peak of his fame and fortune. Over the years, he turned the place into a kind of fantasy land for a kid with an unlimited allowance. The zoo featured lions, tigers, elephants, and an alligator pond. And the amusement park included a carousel, bumper cars, and a Ferris wheel. Jackson regularly invited local school kids and other groups to frolic at his private playground. But there was a dark side. In 1993, Jackson was accused of child molestation, leading to a civil lawsuit that eventually was settled. But in 2003, authorities arrested him on charges of molesting a different child at the ranch. Jackson stood trial in 2005 in nearby Santa Maria and was acquitted. But associates said the legal ordeal took its toll, and Jackson told many in his circle he would never return to Neverland. While he traveled the globe, the estate was mothballed. The exotic animals were removed, and the staff, which once numbered 150, was reduced to fewer than 10. Early in 2008, Jackson defaulted on a $24 million loan secured by Neverland. Days before the property and its contents were to be auctioned off on the steps of a Santa Barbara courthouse on March 19, 2008, Los Angeles-based Colony Capital bought the note. Instead of foreclosing, Colony CEO Tom Barrick, a friend and business associate of Jackson's manager at the time, struck an unusual agreement with the singer. Under the arrangement, Jackson may profit from the sale of his old home, assuming Colony can sell it for enough to make its money back. Now Colony is in the process of bringing the ranch back to life and taking steps to remove the taint of scandal. It has changed the name back to Sycamore Valley Ranch, the one the original developer gave it, and has removed many of Jackson's eccentric touches. The renovations have so far cost more than $3 million. The ranch is situated on some of the most desirable real estate in California, and Colony believes it could be worth a fortune to the right buyer. But it also says it can afford to wait, possibly 3 years or more, for that buyer to emerge and for the real estate market to stabilize. In the meantime, the once and future Neverland remains unoccupied. For the Wall Street Journal, I'm Ethan Smith in Los Angeles.
And last year, he narrowly avoided foreclosure on his Neverland ranch after defaulting on a $24.5 million mortgage. But a private equity firm acquired the note, and that company could now decide to make Neverland some kind of museum like Elvis's Graceland, so the investment could still pay off.